We cannot tell the precise moment when friendship is formed. As in filling a vessel drop by drop, there is at last a drop which makes it run over. So in a series of kindnesses, there is at last one which makes the heart run over. Are words more powerful than guns? Can they feed the hungry or stop the fearful from spreading their hate? If money is just a tool, if God is just a tool, if a gun is just a tool to be used for good or evil, then please, God, make my words a tool that will move men to feed their brothers, to respect their sisters, to penetrate the hearts and minds of the hateful and drain their blackened blood. Then, let my words nourish and rebirth them as human beings. You came of the Lord Adam and the Lady Eve, said Aslan, and that is both honor enough to erect the head of the poorest beggar and shame enough to bow the shoulders of the greatest emperor on earth. Be content. Our blood all runs red, the weary, the poor, the priests. No matter the melanin in your skin, no matter who makes your heart flutter, no matter if you sleep in a palace or over an exhaust grating, or in a crack house, or on the wrong side of an arbitrarily placed wall, or in the White House. The youth will change the world. It is inevitable. Let us give them tools. They cannot use our experience, as they do not live in the world we experienced. They cannot use our guns, as these have proven too accurate for daily use. They cannot use our money, as we have none left ourselves. But we can give them words. Words of equality and peace. Words of respect and power. We can give them a safe space to test their words and refine them, to sharpen their tools, and over their lifetime, change their world and succeed where we have.